Tonight on KSL Outdoors. It's not a giant, but it's a good one.
An overabundance of small walleye is drawing anglers to starvation. Plus,
ooh, this feels like a better one.
Smallmouth and even a few rainbows.
The trifecta at Starvation. I'm Adam Eagle, and let's go fishing.
KSL Outdoors with Adam Eagle is brought to you by your local Ford stores.
Well, you're looking to have a fish fry? If you are, Starvation's the place to be. Hi, I'm Adam Eagle along with Dan Smith from Fish Tech, and you brought us out to Starvation to do what?
We're going to catch a bunch of smaller fish for a fish fry or tacos. We're not looking for the big one today because I like to eat them smaller fish. They're a lot tastier and they're not as mushy.
And smaller fish, you mean walleye?
Walleye, and we might catch some bass too. All we'll right. have to just wait and see.
Let's go see if we can go do it.
We can do it.
All right. We're good. There's already a few boats already ahead of us. There's quite a few people here for a Wednesday.
Yeah, doesn't anybody work?
This is work, right?
Oh yeah, that's right.
So head down lake towards the bridge?
Yeah, get on the other side of the bridge.
All right, let's see what we can find.
We can find them.
All right, what are we gonna start with?
Jig head and a night crawler.
All right, here we go.
Starvation is no doubt one of the best walleye fisheries in the state, especially when you talk numbers. Having too many walleye, however, can be a problem, especially in a lake with a lot of predators like Starvation. Too many mouths to feed can lead to a crash in the population.
We caught them from here all the way down. Okay.
Dan recently caught a bunch of 10 to 12 inch walleye right about here. We'll see if we can duplicate his past success and thin the herd, so to speak.
All right, let's see your famous jigs here.
There it is, right there.
That's it, just a jig head and a worm.
Just a jig head and a night crawler.
Why chartreuse, Dan?
Because it UV reflects off of it and makes it bright under the water.
Yeah.
And walleye have sensitive eyes and it just makes them mad.
Yeah. Well, let's go make them mad.
We're gonna. Half a night crawler on a jig head. The only reason why I use a half a night crawler is because usually they bite the back half off anyway, so you might as well use a half of one. That way you get the hook.
Pretty simple. Let's go get a night crawler.
So you throw it out, let it hit the bottom and sit there for a second. Roll up the slack. And you just move it about, 2 feet, let it sit again. Just keep working it like that until one picks it up. That's a good fisherman.
Best one on the lake.
That's right.
There he is. Oh, he got off. No, he got on. It is a little.
Little small.
Little baby. Wrong species for this morning.
That's okay. They're still fun.
There we go. Get him?
Mm-hmm.
There's a fish.
You get him?
Yeah, little walleye.
Hit her.
Perfect size, huh? There's a better walleye.
If it doesn't go back in, that'll be an eater.
Boy, just lots and lots and lots of these little fish in here right now. This is a great time to come up. I mean, that's pretty small. I think we could fillet him, don't you think, Dan?
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Don't feel bad about taking a limit of them home. We're gonna do that today. Oh, better get some water in the dead well. Oh, there he is. Oh, that's a good fish. Whoa, I don't know what this is. This
gotta rainbow.
It might be a rainbow. Mm-hmm. The old starvation steelhead, people like to call him. And look at that, just slammed it. What a fun fish.
Here, you want the net?
You know what, I'm gonna keep him and smoke him. Yeah, let's.
Oh, where'd he go? That's a nice rainbow.
Yeah, just a great bycatch. And that's the other thing. You bring your kids up here, you're fishing for walleye. Same technique. Oh, hold on. Look at that. Just a nice chunky rainbow. Yeah, he's going into the smoker. I enjoy catching and eating a walleye, but those Well, slimers are pretty fun too.
Heck yeah.
The tug is the drug. You little dog, Dan.
Why am I a dog?
You're killing them.
Looks like dinner to me.
There he is. Just a dead stick on that one. Just felt a little bit of weight. You know, don't feel too bad about keeping your limit of 10 of these guys. There's obviously a good spawn that went off. And by taking a few of these smaller ones, you'll ensure that there's some bigger ones, fewer mouths to feed later on here at Starvation. Hey, more here in a moment, but first let's check your knowledge of starvation in this week's climate quiz question.
Starvation Reservoir is one of the premier walleye fisheries in Utah, with numerous large walleye over 10 pounds being pulled from its clear waters each year. The reservoir is also home to smallmouth bass, yellow perch, rainbow trout, brown trout, cutthroat trout, carp, and a few chub. Our climate quiz question tonight is, can you name the two new species of fish that have been recently stocked or relocated to Starvation? Once you know the species, log on to our KSL Outdoors Facebook page, give us the correct answer, and while you're at it, give us a like. We'll then randomly select and announce a winner on our page the following week. The winner set to walk away with a Climate Static V sleeping pad. And our answer to last week's question, which was, how many acres has been enhanced or restored under the DWR's sage-grouse management plan? Well, according to the DWR's website, 1.2 million acres have been enhanced or restored for the greater sage-grouse. KSL Outdoors, powered by Ford. We'll be right back to Starvation.
KSL Outdoors is also brought to you by Sportsman's Warehouse, Fish Tech Outfitters, Utah State Parks, Burt Brothers, Climate, Intermountain Wind and Solar, King's Camo, and Camp Chef.
I like to work the bait with my rod, not with my reel.
Uh-huh.
I just reel a slack out and then I lift it with my rod, and if I feel any pressure,
I hit it. Yeah.
Because it's not a, sometimes you don't even feel the bite. All it is just a spongy feel on the end.
Hook sets are free?
Yes, they are. Oh, unless you get one like that.
Nice. That's a good walleye.
Yeah, that's another one.
It's not.
He hit that one on the run.
Welcome back to Starvation Reservoirs. We target some pan-sized walleye.
There's a double.
There we go.
Bunch of cookie cutters. But we're getting close to limiting out.
There's one. There we go. I think yours a little bigger. All right. There's some right under.
There he is. Oh, we can catch up to him.
Every few years, DWR biologists sample Starvation to get an idea on how the fishery is doing. This summer, their netting efforts showed that perch numbers were down for the second year in a row. On the flip side, they saw many of these small 10 to 14 inch walleye. Now, the small walleye are a product of the numerous 24 inch walleye we saw in Starvation back in 2015. If we hope to have bigger fish in the future, we've got to keep some of these smaller fish.
Boy, there's just a boatload of fish down there. Bunch of little guys, but man,
that's what we're after.
Fun to catch. You know, it's as big as any perch you might catch.
Yeah.
And keep, so why not keep a limit of 10 walleye? Hold on, buddy. And there's only about maybe four bites on the whole fish, but that's okay. When you got 10 of them, you got enough. Oh, there's a fish. Walleye?
Yep.
Yeah, little walleye. Keeper or not? What do you think?
Yeah.
I kept one that small.
Yeah, we'll keep it.
Walleye aren't always the easiest fish to catch or to get kids into, but right now at Starvation would be a great time to introduce them to Mr. Eye. And you never know, Starvation is known to put out the occasional monster.
There he is. Well, this one's a little better. Feels a little heavier.
Want to get the net on that one?
Yep, it's a good one. Got to net the big one. It's not a giant, but it's a good one.
That's a good one.
Best eye of the day.
Yeah.
The idea behind thinning them out a little bit is if you don't, there's just too many predators in this system. And so Natalie has told me that, you know, they're trying to put more forage in here for these fish. Thinning them out doesn't hurt. That's a good one. We were going to let this guy go because, well, he's a big fish or bigger fish, but his air bladder pops. So not equipped to handle that. So we're going to have to keep him. So that's 18. I've got one more and you've got one more. You know, a good idea if you're going down to Lake Powell to catch stripers or even walleye is to cut their gills, get some shears, cut their gills, bleed them out. I think it makes the flesh a little whiter, a little less blood in it, and I don't know, I think it's just more appealing to me when it's on the plate. Dan's going to show you how to fillet and show you the difference between a walleye that hasn't been cut and one that has in tonight's Fish Tech Fish Report. How about it, Dan?
Hi, I'm Dan Smith from Fish Tech Outfitters. As Adam was saying, if you bleed your fish, you get a lot better quality of meat. This one here, all the blood's out of. This one here, we didn't bleed. If you notice, there's lots of blood in this one. This is pure white, sweet meat. I definitely would rather eat the one that's been bled out. Now, if you got a whole bunch of fish to clean, the best way to do it is filleting them with electric fillet knife. It's really simple and easy. You take the fish, lay it down, grab your fillet knife, cut it right behind the gills, turn the fillet knife, run it along the rib cage, flip it over, lay it out. I always carry a hand knife with me to get the rib cage out. So all you do is just cut the rib cage out, throw it away, there you go. Nice, sweet, clean meat. It's really not that hard, and it's a heck of a lot easier with electric fillet knife. If you're having problems filleting fish, come on down to the store and I'll demonstrate it on a mounted fish. Now for the nice fishing line.
Welcome back to KSL Outdoors, back here at Starvation, along with Dan Smith from Fish Tech. We got enough fish tacos.
I believe we do.
Yeah, we got a limit of walleye. It took us about 3 hours, but a lot of other species in here. Let's target a little bigger smallmouth, maybe.
We're going to give it a shot.
All right, what are you going to do?
I'm going to throw this little swim bait.
Okay.
I caught some good fish on it 3 days ago, so we're going to try it again.
All right, I'm going to go rummage in my box and see what I got. All right, what are we gonna do? I think I've got just a little maniac minnow. It's always been pretty good for me. And quarter ounce jig head, try and get a little deeper maybe, see if we can catch some fish.
Come on, fishy, where are you at?
Oh, there's a fish.
You get him?
First cast, and it's not a giant, but bigger than any of the ones we caught while we were walleye fishing. Just a little chunk. Nice little guy. Look at the belly on that guy.
Oh, they're healthy.
Oh, man.
All the fish in here are healthy.
That is a chunky.
Oh, missed him.
Sorry, I was gonna show him off to you and he slipped out of my hands. Get a bite, Dan? There he is.
You got one. They're still here.
What'd you get him on?
Had a little swim bait. Yeah, it's about the same size as the one you got.
But there's bigger in here.
Yeah, we caught a two something in the tournament in here. 10 incher.
Yep. Let's find some 13s.
That's what we need.
There's another one, but it doesn't feel very big. Nope. Just another good fish.
There is a grundle of them in here that size. And it wouldn't hurt to take a limit out if you wanted to.
Sure.
You know, there's 6 to a limit.
So. Mm-hmm. Take the small ones, leave the big ones. Yep. Kind of like the walleye.
Same thing as the walleye.
Yep.
You got to thin them out so they'll get bigger.
These fish seem to be out kind of on the end of these points that we're fishing.
There's a little drop off right here. It comes out and drops off. Any place in here where you can find a ledge, they're gonna be sitting on the bottom of that ledge waiting for stuff to come over, to ambush.
Nice hit.
Well, that one hit like a freight train.
That's a little better fish.
I think it might be.
Yeah, that's the best fish of the day, I think. It's not a giant, but it's still getting up there.
It might be 12 inches.
There he is. Okay, this is a little better fish. Don't know if it's a giant, but it definitely feels heavier.
The maniac minnow is working.
Yeah? No, it's not much bigger. Just a little bit bigger fight. Look at all the crawdads it's spitting out. James Bradshaw makes these lures, and I've caught panfish, trout, walleye, smallmouth, largemouth, that changeable craw. That color, my favorite right there.
Oh, maybe.
Ooh, this feels like a better one.
This might be the one.
That's one of the better of the day. Yeah. I don't think it's the biggest, but it's close. Almost every one of them are spitting up crawdads, aren't they?
Yeah, and this one, you can see the crawdads in his belly.
Here, yeah, right there. Big old bulge.
Yep, yep.
Nice and healthy.
Yes, they are.
Well, good deal.
Well, you can't catch big ones every day.
No, we did catch one nice walleye.
Yeah, we caught a big walleye today.
Yeah, not too bad. Let him go.
I'd take six of those in a walleye classic.
I'll bet you would. Hey, we'll have more here from Starvation in a moment. But first, down a different trail in tonight's Utah Field Guide. All right, Dan, I'm still in your spot.
Spending its entire life in fresh water, Utah's only salmon, the kokanee salmon, is a landlocked form of the sockeye salmon. Kokanee salmon are a popular non-native game fish found in Utah and have been introduced into several water bodies in the state, most notably Strawberry and Flaming Gorge. And 2 years ago, here at Starvation. Kokanee are silver blue for most of their life, but turn a bright red color in the fall of their last year prior to spawning. Kokanee spawn over gravel beds and they will often dig pits called reds to lay their eggs. Much like sockeye salmon, each kokanee salmon returns to the area of its birth to spawn. Kokanee live for 3 to 4 years and die after spawning is complete. If you'd like to witness this annual September ritual, you're in luck. The DWR is hosting two kokanee viewing events, both on September 16th. One will be at the Strawberry Visitor Center at Strawberry Reservoir. The Visitor Center is located just off Highway 40, about 20 miles southeast of Heber City. The other event will be on Sheep Creek, about 6 miles south of Manila, just before the river empties into Flaming Gorge. Biologists will be on hand to answer questions and show off these fluorescent red fish. For more information on both events, check our Outdoors calendar page. You'll find it at kSLTV.com.
Boy, for coming out walleye fishing here at Starvation, to have a little wind like we did today, it's perfect. A lot of the walleye anglers call it a walleye chop. Let's find out that recreation forecast for your next outdoor adventure by turning over the guys and gals in the weather department. Welcome back to KSL Outdoors, back here at Starvation. Hey, we want to welcome some longtime friends to our outdoors family. That's right, King's Camel is now an official sponsor of KSL Outdoors. Jed, Ryan, Kevin, and the boys, we've got a lot of hunts planned with them this fall. So if you happen to be out hunting yourself and you want to catch up on some of the episodes, you can do it by downloading our KSL TV app, or you can check us out on our iTunes podcast as well. Well, the fall hunts are here. The fall fishing should start picking up. We expect to see lots of pictures. And don't forget, we also take video. If you have video, you can't upload them on our website. So go ahead and just send me a note at aeagle@ksl.com or outdoors@ksl.com. And we'll work out a way to get that video and get you submitted into our snapshot of the week. Now your turn with the best of the week, our snapshot of the week.
We kick it off with an old friend out enjoying his family. My mentor and good buddy, Reese Stein, was out visiting his family down in Florida. They took some time to fish and ended up loading up on shark. They then took them home and gobbled them up. It looks like it was a great trip with the grandkids, Colonel. Kyan just turned 11, and for his birthday, his grandpa gave him a fly rod and reel. Of course, grandpa had to immediately take Kyan on a fishing trip to break it in. Grandpa spent all afternoon teaching Kyan the skills required to fish for those wily cutthroats. What a great grandpa and what a great birthday. Fishing at Yuba Reservoir this summer, 3-year-old Paxton latched into his biggest fish to date, this giant carp. Paxton kept saying the big fish was going to pull him in, but he didn't want any help, and he ended up landing the big fish all on his own with his little rod. Paxton was pretty proud of his catch. The mountains of central Utah were ringing to the sounds of hounds on this year's fall bear hunt. Scott's 75-year-old dad, Franklin, waited 11 years for the tag, and with the help of Sorensen Outdoors, he was able to catch up with this beautiful brood. A once-in-a-lifetime experience for all. And finally, our winner tonight caught up with a group of goats in the backcountry. Matthew and his wife were on a backpacking trip in the High Uintas. While exploring, they encountered rock chucks, moose, deer, but never expected to come so close to a herd of mountain goats. Matt says they came down to the meadow they were in to graze, and he and his wife were able to watch them for over an hour. Well, Matt, what a magical experience to have with your wife. And the next time you two head back up into the High Uintas, you'll have our cool prize to take with you, as you just won our snapshot of the week. Remember, submit your pictures or video plus an explanation of your latest outdoor adventures online at ksltv.com. The winner each week wins the new Striker multi-fuel backpacking stove that can be fueled by propane or butane. Plus, the winner is also entered into our Ford Trucks quarterly Facebook giveaway for a Camp Chef pellet grill.
Build your outdoor kitchen with Camp Chef, the way to cook outdoors.
Like you were saying, the walleye, that's our biggest one today. A lot of cigars, like this guy, but there's still a filet on that.
Oh, heck yeah. You keep a perch that big.
Yeah, you would. That's true.
You know, everybody says, oh, they're small.
And these are just as good, if not a little better than perch.
A little sweeter meat.
Yeah. And like we were talking about earlier, this is a really easy place to come in if you've never caught a lot of walleye to come and do it right now. Well, thanks, sir. That was a lot of fun. And I imagine this is still going to continue for quite a while.
It'll probably till freezes.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a good time.
You betcha.
Cool, thanks.
A lot of fun.
Hey, don't forget to bring your kids out to Starvation, catch some steelhead, some smallmouth, some walleye. Get out here and have a blast. I'm Adam Equal, KSL Outdoors. We'll see you next weekend. Good night.